parrots, the birds that talk. These tropical birds have been researched for years, revealing their high levels of intelligence. One researcher found that each parrot speaks its own unique iteration, like saying its name. When another parrot hears that, it repeats the exact sound. It's its way of saying it received the sending bird's message. Julianne Rose of Wildlife Safari tells us that it's not just about repeating our language.
Parrots are known for their words and their mimicry, but Amazons, they're not so much about words as they are about noises and mimicking sounds that they hear. So he'll do a really great car alarm and a siren. He can mimic the noises of some other birds. And he'll also whistle a variety of songs. I would say that one of the communication methods that he uses the most is whistling. And he'll whistle back and forth with us in the office while we're doing paperwork and writing programs. But he definitely is an animal that would not make a good pet. He is a stunning bird, but he requires a lot of stimulation and a lot of socialization to be happy. Since he is so smart, scientists think he's got the same brain power as a human kindergarten student would. He needs a lot to do. So he'll do a lot of exploration of his environment with his beak and his tongue here. Lots of shredding, sticking his head in things, and nibbling and chewing. He does a lot of picking apart of fabric and leather pieces and beads. Beads are definitely a toy that he seems to prefer more over everything else. And he also needs a lot of activity going on around him. So in the wild, he would live in a flock of easily 100 to 200 birds. So in captivity, the people that are around him on a day-to-day basis, they become his flock. So it's really important for us as his keepers that we are making sure that he gets a lot of socializing time with us and out and about in the park. So he goes on a lot of programs with us. As you can see, he is quite content to be here. We didn't have to talk him into it at all. He'll come to meetings with us. He'll come to schools. And he is really just a fun animal to bring out to meet people because he has such an engaging personality. And these guys in the wild, for the most part, they're doing well. They do unfortunately face some pressure from illegal capture for the pet trade. And it is important if you ever do decide you're going to have a pet bird, I would recommend a parakeet. They're quite a bit easier than parrots like this guy. You make sure that they have a band. That way you can track which breeder they came from and you know for sure that they haven't been pulled illegally from the wilds. He is an animal that's going to eat quite a bit of different foods. He is very much a fruit and a vegetable and a nut eater. And this beak here that he has is specialized for cracking into particularly hard or tough foods. And his feet down here, he has two toes in the front and two toes in the back, and they bend to form a little cup almost so he can hold on to food and bring it up towards his beak and nibble on it. And he's a super, super messy eater, which in captivity, not so fantastic, but in the wild, him being a messy eater is very, very important because he'll pick up, let's say, a piece of fruit, take a couple bites, throw it on the ground, and then that fruit on the ground will become food for animals that aren't able to climb high up into the canopy. And it also can grow and start new trees, which will feed other animals for generations to come. So they have a super important role in the ecosystem.
Julianne Rose and the parrot Boo appeared on Adventures in Education in 2016.
Now, how are those birds doing in the wild? Are they endangered? Or are they in pretty good population?
There are a few that are endangered. For the most part, parrots are stable for the moment, but they do feel a lot of pressure from the pet trade. Unfortunately, especially in their home countries, there are a lot of individuals who will go out and collect them right out of the nest illegally and then try to sell them to tourists or wealthier individuals that live in the country.
I see.
So, the takeaway is that parrots are not a good choice for a pet.